You see, in our lives, we have so many things to complain about. One difficulty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends, and we start complaining. We complain about our body, our work, about finances, about our rizq, about our connection with the people. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is flipping this completely around. He is telling, remember the good times. Remember those times when you did have things, when you are blessed with the ni'mat, with the blessings, with the mercy. Remember those times. You see, sometimes it so happens that we go throughout a whole day without saying shukran lillah. We go throughout a whole week sometimes saying alhamdulillah. Sometimes it so happens that it goes a whole month that we forget to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us, remember of the good times that you had in your life. Be thankful to me, and if you do, I will surely increase you in your favors. One of the companions of the ninth holy Imam, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi, by the name of Abu Hashim al-Ja'fari, he comes in the presence of Imam Muhammad Taqi al-Hadi. And as soon as he comes, the Imam is looking at him and he realizes Abu Hashim is in a not very good mood. He understands that Abu Hashim has actually come here to complain. You see, many a time you may see someone from far and you know that, yep, he's not in a good mood today. So Imam, at the same way, recognized that Abu Hashim is not in a good mood today. So as Abu Hashim comes in the presence of the Imam, he greets him. The Imam responds to him in his greeting. Before Abu Hashim could respond with and he could initiate any conversation, Imam starts the conversation and he asks, "Oh Abu Hashim, which of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessings have you come to thank for today? Have you come to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have provided you iman, faith, so that the fire of hell will never touch your body? Or have you come to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have provided you well-being and health so that you are able to obey Him? Or have you come to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have provided you with the contentment so that you are never in a position to be in a lowly position? Oh Abu Hashim, which of Allah's blessings have you come to thank for today?" Abu Hashim hadn't come to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for anything. Rather, he had come to complain. Rather, he had come with a very bad mood. However, Imam Muhammad al-Hadi is trying to tell us that whenever you or yourself is looking at the world as a glass of half empty water, turn it around. Look at the glass of water in this world as half full. Concentrate on the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has indeed given you, has surely blessed you with. And what beautiful things that Imam is highlighting for us. The first thing that he highlighted Abu Hashim was, "Oh Abu Hashim, have you come to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the iman, for the faith that He has given you so that your body will never touch the fire of hell?" Subhanallah, is this reason not enough for us to prostrate for a long amount of time, to spend our lives in prostration, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided us, either raised us in a family or has guided us later in our life so that we believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the prophethood of His messenger, with the wilayat of Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib, and on the ghaybah of the 12th hujjat al-qa'im ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif? Is this reason not enough for us to thank Allah? On the second level, he says, "Oh Abu Hashim, have you come to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have provided you health so that you are able to obey Him?" Alhamdulillah, I have health so that I am able to stand tall in prayers. I have health so that I am able to complete the lengthy fasts of Shahr Ramadan. I have health so that I am able to walk long distances in performing Hajj, in performing the Ziyarah. Alhamdulillah, I have the ability to talk, the ability to recite the Holy Quran. I have the ability to think. I have the ability to interact with the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala properly. Is this reason not enough for us to spend our entire life and to say Alhamdulillah? On the third level, what does Imam Hadi try to tell Abu Hashim? He says, "Oh Abu Hashim, have you come to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have given you the level of contentment that will make sure that you are never in a position to go out in the streets and beg?" How many of us, alhamdulillah, shukranillah, can say that we have that level of satisfaction, that level of contentment, qana'at, that we are not in a situation to go outside of our home and beg in the streets. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided us with so much things that we have to thank Him for. All we have to do is reflect on the things that He has provided us, on the bounties that He has provided us with. Many a times you will see in this world there are problems of depression. Now I agree, there are some cases of depression that are legitimate cases of depression, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help those individuals. But a lot of the cases of depression is not because of pure depression. It's because of the lack of reflection. It's because complacency in life. Because there are people, there are individuals, myself included, this advice is first to me and then to yourselves. There are a lot of people that complain more to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than actually concentrate on the positive things that Allah has blessed them with. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed me with a beautiful family, with a beautiful community, with food on my plate, with roof over my head. Are these reasons not enough for me to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for and not be complacent? لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ If you are thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will surely increase you in your favors.